Oh hey, welcome to POSB's The Parent Board. Now, one thing that I've realized from talking to a lot of mothers is that there is no one size fits all. Everyone is different and everyone's just trying to find what's best for their parenting and education style for their child. So to chat a little bit more, I've got Sherlyn who's gonna come on a video call and chat a little bit more. Sherlyn, are you there?
Hi Kelly!
Okay, tell me everything about Thea.
She has just turned one and it's been so fun because she's so much more interactive right now. And lately, she's been tottering around the house a lot more as well.
Oh, this stage is the best, you know, when they're just in like their little nappies and they're waddling around like in the cutest. Okay, so now that she's one, what sort of learning activities have you guys started to introduce to her?
We like her to learn more organically. So she looks around her surroundings, and she picks what she likes and we'll just go from there.
How does this type of activity benefit her?
It benefits her in the sense that she gets to go at her own pace. So she doesn't ever feel like mummy's forcing something down my throat. It helps to also build on her curiosities and her preferences and her interests.
So with Sienna, like, she loved reading, right? So we would end up picking up a book and we would read together. But what about you guys? How did you first introduce these activities to Thea?
So when it comes to reading, what we do is we bring the book to her, we sit with her, and we read dramatically and enthusiastically to her. And after that, I do realize that she starts to pick up books on her own, to enjoy her own reading time, and it's really nice to watch as a mum.
It's quite important, especially when you're looking at education in the preschool years, to try and find something that is similar to your style at home, because you don't want to have conflicting values, right?
Yeah, that's what a lot of parents look for, because consistency is beneficial. We see that when there's routine at home, our children behave a lot better. But I like to think that children are a lot more adaptable than us adults. And actually, if there is a differing method or a different sort of way the preschool runs, it might be a good thing. If both methods are good, then we enjoy the best of both worlds.
So as an educator yourself then, what sort of advice would you give to parents on choosing the right preschool education?
It will be good for parents to head down to the preschool with their children to take a look at the space, get a feel, are they cheerful, are they patient, how do they interact with your child. So these are probably things that I'll look for first before I would perhaps say I want to have a look at the curriculum.
If you didn't already know, you can actually use your CDA to pay for your education, which the Ministry of Social and Family Development have actually approved some of these merchants. So it's very important that you're doing your research before all of this and realizing that there are avenues to help offset some of these costs as well. Aside from then the academics and keeping their brains in check and the social interaction, there's also the physical side of things as well, making sure that your child is actually physically growing well.
Yeah.
So what's your take on like vitamins and supplements and all of that?
I think if our children are eating well, then we don't have much to worry about because they should be drawing all these nutrients from the food that they eat. For Thea, she eats pretty well, thankfully.
Oh, you're really lucky. Sienna's been a little bit of a picky eater and we ended up having to make sure that she was eating the right sort of things through like adding on like vitamins and stuff like that. So I think it's important to remember, especially as parents, that you can actually use your CDA to not only pay for your child's education, but also for supplements as well. You can actually offset some of those costs. So it really does come in handy. But when did you introduce solids to Thea's diet?
So we started introducing solids to her when she was about 5.5 months old. We saw that she could sit pretty well on the high chair. And when we were eating, she would move her mouth a little and look at the food.
Oh, so cute.
Yeah. She will start with the carbs and move on to the proteins and the vegetables come last. So by the time she might be full and there might be lots of veggies left.
You know what? I think that sounds like me too. I mean, okay, well, Sherlyn, thank you so much for sharing with us. Like, I think I've really learned a lot more about your style and how yes, it may be different from my style in certain ways, but I love how observant you are. For other mothers out there, if friends maybe reached out to you for advice on the best education style for little kids especially, what would you tell them?
I would say first to always go with what you're comfortable with and what your child would be comfortable with. Choose something that you think you might like, try it out, and if it works, commit to it, execute it, and be confident about it.
Awesome. Great words of advice. Sherlyn, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So if you're looking for useful content on parenting, from raising your little one to planning finances for the family, head over to POSB Home. You'll find exactly what you're looking for there.